How do you engrave pencil lead was not a question I had on my 2025 CNC bingo card, but here I am. Last week, I was working on a video for Carbide 3D trying to machine what might be the smallest feature anyone's ever attempted on a CNC router. But in the course of my experimentation, physics threw me a curveball. Here's what happened. I was engraving some text on a block of aluminum going smaller and smaller to see at what point a Shapeoko 5 Pro would no longer provide legible results. The answer was an impressive 0.4 millimeters or about 1/64 of an inch. But as I was examining the results and using a mechanical pencil to point out features for the camera, the fact that the smallest of the engravings could be dwarfed by a 0.7 millimeter pencil lead got me thinking. Could I engrave on the pencil lead itself? The first problem I had to overcome was knowing where to engrave. Pencil lead is too small to locate with a probe, so I had to be able to drop it in a pocket I knew the location of. But I don't have an end mill small enough to machine a 0.7 millimeter slot, so I designed a strategically squiggly pocket that could be milled with a larger end mill and still hug a pencil lead from both sides. The second problem was time, the time of day. Our shop isn't climate controlled, so as the day went on, thermal expansion caused the Shapeoko's engravings to drift at a microscopic level. Most people don't need to worry about this, but unfortunately I do. It took some trial and error to walk the Shapeoko back on target, but once I got the corrected coordinates dialed in, the machine crushed it. And they say science should be repeatable, so I did it again. Now, I call that a success. Is this the smallest thing anyone's ever tried to machine on a CNC router? I'd wager it's possible, but I can't say for certain. However, I do know that the Shapeoko 5 Pro is more than precise enough for anything I'll ever need to make. Unless, of course, I decide to start an aerospace job shop, but that's not going to be today.